Ivory has been producing their floating soap for well over a century now, and in that time they've become one of the most popular soap brands in the world. For many years, the company has maintained that the discovery of its trademark floating soap was a complete accident. But exactly how true is this? For those of you who are not familiar with Ivory brand soap, in a nutshell, its two key selling points are that it's incredibly pure, 99.44% pure, meaning 99.44% fat and alkali, and that also it floats, making it superior to all other kinds of soap because you don't need to grope around in the bottom of the bath to find it. Of course, that only applies if you're one of the 0.1% of people who still take a bath. These two traits have made Ivory soap one of the most popular and enduring brands, and both features have been played up by the company itself in its advertising for almost as long as the soap has existed. If anyone is curious about why Ivory soap floats, the soap is produced in such a way as to ensure that air is whipped into the soap mixture before it sets. As a result, the final product contains numerous tiny air bubbles which work together to make the soap ever so slightly less dense than water, allowing it to float. These air bubbles also serve a dual function of making the soap produce a more consistent and bubbly lather when used, another fact the company has historically drawn attention to in its advertising. No surprises. This is actually something you can observe for yourself by popping a bar of Ivory soap into your microwave, you know, for science. As for how this discovery came about, for over a century, Ivory has insisted that the invention of floating soap was a happy accident that occurred as a result of an unnamed employee accidentally leaving a batch of soap mixture to mix for too long while he was on his lunch break. The story continues that when the employee returned and realized his mistake, he reasoned that since nothing new had been added to the mixture, there was no reason to throw out the batch. In some versions of the story, the employee told his manager about the mistake, who came to the same conclusion. In both versions of the story, the mixture was then sent to be set and cut into bars, at which point it was promptly forgotten about. That was until a few weeks later, when orders began flooding in for floating soap, which confused the workers at Ivory, who had no idea that such a product existed, let alone that they even sold it. After receiving dozens of orders for this mythical product, the company conducted an internal investigation until the tainted batch was found, at which point they came to the realization that the extra mixing must have added air to the mixture, making the soap light enough to float. While this may sound a little too convenient, there are well-documented cases of such happy accidents happening. For example, artificial sweetener was discovered because a researcher ate a sandwich after forgetting to wash his hands. Superglue was also invented by accident, not once, but rather twice. Further, the slinky was originally supposed to be a tension spring in horsepower meters in battleships before the inventor accidentally knocked one of them off his desk. The list of famous accidental inventions, it really does go on and on. And as Ivory has insisted, that's how it happened 12 decades or so ago. So, case closed, right? Well, not exactly. Perhaps the first tip-off should have been the unnamed employee. These sorts of stories that are vague on specifics on names and dates, while overly detailed and elaborate on the rest, often tend to be false or wildly exaggerated. But the nail in the coffin came in 2004, when this accidental floating soap origin story was officially debunked. In a strange twist, it just so happened to have been debunked by one of Ivory's own archivists when they were researching for a book about the history of Procter & Gamble, the company that owns Ivory. According to the archivist, a notebook from 1863 was found in which a chemist working for P&G nonchalantly noted, "I made floating soap today. I think we'll make all of our stock that way." But here's the weirdest part. The chemist who made that discovery was none other than James Gamble, the son of the man who co-founded the company, James Gamble Sr. Yet somehow, the fact that he invented one of the company's most famous and enduring products was forgotten about for over a century. Although Gamble discovered the process to make soap float way back in 1863 and seemingly had plans to make all our stock that way, the first bar of Ivory floating soap sold to consumers happened 16 years later, advertised from its very debut as the soap that floats. And now for some bonus facts. In 1923, Ivory hired legendary PR man Edward Bernays to advertise their brand. After being hired, Bernays convinced them to give thousands of free bars of soap to schools so children could carve them up into sculptures. As a result, soap carving became a big thing, leading to an increase in both sales and brand awareness. And now for another bonus fact. In 2001, the company intentionally released just over 1,000 bars of their soap which wouldn't float and offered a share of a $250,000 prize to anyone who could find one. As far as we could find, none of the sinking bars were ever turned in, presumably reflecting the fact that most people shower these days so they wouldn't really notice unless they made an effort to check for floating soap. Sales nonetheless increased by a good margin, thanks to this ad campaign. And now for another bonus fact. In 1994, scientists asked a bunch of children to taste test some soap, apparently for science, and they discovered that Ivory soap tasted the least disgusting overall, which is something, we guess. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below and do not forget to subscribe. Also, new channel from me called Highlight History. You'll find that linked to below. And as always, thank you for watching.